Legislators filed two lawsuits in state Supreme Court today, claiming the Republican governor has exceeded her veto authority and isn't doing enough to protect unemployment funds. That could mean small businesses will pay the price. Action 7 News anchor Tanya Mendez has more on a story you saw first on 7.
Six Democratic state legislators signed their names to this 80-page lawsuit. They're challenging a governor's line item veto that eliminated a boost in taxes on businesses to shore up our leaky unemployment fund.
It's a separation of powers issue. The governor is supposed to execute the laws of New Mexico, and the legislature is supposed to pass the laws.
Representative Mimi Stewart is one of the legislators suing. She says, believe it or not, the tax hike was something many small businesses wanted. Here's why. If there's no money for unemployment, the state might borrow from the feds, and small businesses would foot a higher bill. So they claim better to have a small tax now than take a large hit later. But Martinez doesn't think a tax is the right answer.
Right now, small businesses aren't getting increased taxes to their companies, to their businesses. We want to hold back on those taxes, so we intend to have a permanent fix for that.
The governor plans to take up the issue during the next legislative session.
In January, we're going to deal with this issue no matter what.
She maintains the line item veto is legal and right, and she says she's not the first governor to do it.
It's the very same kind of line item veto that Bill Richardson did with the food tax. I think it's interesting to see the same behavior being treated differently.
Tanya Mendez, KOAT Action 7 News.
The lawsuit also names the Secretary of State Anna Duran and the Workforce Solutions Secretary Designate Selena Busey. The second lawsuit was filed by four additional legislators and makes similar claims.